kids, let's learn all about creatures. That's really just another word for animals, and there are so many different kinds of animals. There are animals found in real life, like ponies. Animals that lived way back millions of years ago, like dinosaurs. And animals that exist in your imagination, like dragons and trolls and unicorns. Some are small.
Some are big.
Some are nice. Some are not. But they're all fun to learn about. So get ready for a Wiki for Kids brainstorm. Today's topic, fantastic creatures.
My school project is about horses and ponies. There are so many different types of horses and ponies. Magic horses like unicorns and pegasus, talking horses, walking horses, wild horses, racing horses, earth ponies, crystal ponies. I could go on forever. But hey, hay is for horses. So what do horses and ponies like to eat? Hay and carrots. And some ponies even like to eat cake.
Cake.
Horses and ponies live in all kinds of places. Some live in a land called Equestria. Some live on farms. Some live in the city. Some live in the sea. Okay, so seahorses aren't really real horses, but they're so cool.
Thanks.
Maybe they hang out with narwhals. Narwhals have horns just like unicorns. I wonder if they're cousins.
Hi, meet my cousin Narwhal.
Hi.
What do horses and ponies like to do? Some like to fly. Some like to just go round and round in circles. Some are rocking horses. No, not that kind of rocking horse. There we go. Some horses like to hang out with princesses, but sometimes ponies are princesses. I wonder what unicorns like to do. Oh, I bet they like to pop balloons. Naughty unicorns. Sometimes people ride on horses, like cowboys. I don't know why they don't just call them horse boys. They're not riding cows. In olden days, mailmen used to ride horses super duper fast all across the country to deliver letters. That was called the Pony Express. Jockeys ride horses in big races like the Kentucky Derby. Sometimes people ride in horses. Lots of horses and ponies have names, like Pinkie Pie, Fluttershy, Little Sebastian, Mr. Ed, Seabiscuit, not a seahorse like you might think, Bullseye, and Buttercup. But if I had a horse or pony or unicorn, I would totally give it an awesome name, like Princess of Thunder or Fiery Cupcake. What would you name your horse or pony? Say in the comments. So pretty much, horses and ponies and unicorns and pegasus and alicorns are all really cool, and we should all have our own pet pony. The end.
My project is all about dragons. Dragons come in all different shapes and sizes, but all of them are awesome. They have wings, so they can fly through the air. They can even do tricks. Some dragons are really cute, like Toothless from How to Train Your Dragon. Aw, he doesn't have any teeth. On the other hand, in Sleeping Beauty, Maleficent turns into a dragon with a whole bunch of teeth. It's probably tougher to use a toothbrush. Some dragons breathe fire. They do this to protect their gold or because they just ate a bunch of spicy chicken wings. Why does he even need all that gold? To buy more spicy chicken wings? Other dragons breathe ice. That's handy for when your ice cream is starting to melt.
Thanks.
Some dragons just have bad breath. That's the scariest breath of all. Maybe he needs to brush his teeth too. There are dragons that are big enough for you to ride on. And then there are dragons that are small enough to ride on you. Most kids love dragons. My older sister even likes some called Imagine Dragons. They don't look like regular dragons. I think they're radioactive or something, like Godzilla. Godzilla likes to step on buildings. He's not really a dragon though, more of a dinosaur. We'll talk about dinosaurs later. For now, back to dragons. Dragons are used as symbols for a lot of things. Knights used to have dragons on their shields. During the Chinese New Year, you could see a dragon dance. No, not that kind of dragon dance. That's better. Some dragons are magic, but some are not. This list is starting to drag on. So in conclusion, dragons live in castles and lighthouses, up on mountains and down in caves. They can be cuter than a kitten and friendlier than a dog. Dragons can fly you to school so you don't have to take the bus. And that's why I should have a dragon as a pet.
My cool school project is all about dinosaurs. Dinosaurs lived millions and millions and millions and millions and millions of years ago. That's a lot of years ago. The word dinosaur means terrible lizard. But I don't think they're terrible at all. I think they're cool. Okay, maybe that dino is kind of terrible. Leave some cake for the rest of us, Rex.
Sorry.
Some dinosaurs are small, like the Mosasaurus. That name means mouse lizard. I wonder if the Mosasaurus likes cheese. Some are big, like the Apatosaurus.
Hey, I was born this way.
Some are really, really, really big, like the Titanosaurus. The Titanosaurus was so big that scientists say she might have been as long as 2 Mack trucks and weighed as much as 14 elephants.
Okay, I'll go on a diet.
That reminds me of a joke. What time is it when a Titanosaurus sits on her fence? Time to get a new fence. The Tyrannosaurus Rex, or the T-Rex, is one of the most famously ferocious dinosaurs. But his arms are so tiny, it was probably hard for him to tie his shoes. Did you know there's another dino called the P-Rex? The P stands for Pinocchio. That's because he told so many fibs.
Of course I ate all my peas. Now what's for dessert?
He's called Pinocchio Rex because this dinosaur had a long nose, just like Pinocchio. Plus, he probably didn't eat peas at all because the P-Rex was a carnivore. Carnivores eat meat. Other dinosaurs are leaf eaters. They eat, well, leaves. And some dinosaurs eat anything, like Yoshi. You might call him a nom nom nomivore. Whenever Yoshi eats something, he lays an egg. Dinosaur eggs are really colorful. A Stegosaurus has spikes on his back. But what if there was a Legosaurus? He would be really colorful too. Some dinosaurs can fly, like the Pegasaurus. Just kidding, I made that one up. But the pterodactyl could fly. Even though dinosaurs lived a long time ago, we still find parts of them today. These are called fossils. There are even fossil Pokemon, like Mega Aerodactyl. Scientists can learn a lot about dinosaurs from fossils, like how big the dino was, how long ago it lived, and even how smart they were. They say the Troodon was the smartest dinosaur. Hey Troodon, what's 2 + 2?
2, 2?
Okay, not that smart, but pretty good at ballet. Some dinosaurs were really fast, and some are really slow. To sum it all up, dinosaurs lived a super long time ago, and they were totally awesome, and they couldn't tie their shoes. If I could name my own dinosaur, I'd name it Super Awesome Saurus, or maybe just Calvin. And I'd ride around on it all day, and I'd let all my friends ride on him too. Everybody gets a dino ride. My project is about trolls. These are trolls. Some trolls are big, and others are small, but they all seem to have similar features. Trolls are often very large, smelly, and dirty. This most likely comes from their unhealthy diet of eating only mountain goats. Their skin is very tough and has many shades of gray in its coloring. When trolls are sleeping, they can often be mistaken for a pile of rocks. Their hair is made of bushes and trees, as this helps them hide when they don't want to be seen. A troll with a great hairdo can look like a nice place for a mountain goat to rest and get some shade. Not so in this situation. Sorry, Mr. Goat.
Yeah, it's okay.
Trolls' personalities are a funny thing. They think very highly of themselves, as if they are the smartest in all the land. But in reality, they are not the smartest in all the land.
Hey, I heard that.
Trolls are also very greedy. They don't like to share, and they will get into fights with one another about silly little things. It is this selfishness that prevents trolls from ever being truly happy. So, don't be a troll, be happy. And always be nice to mountain goats.
Want more cool school? Click here! And click here to subscribe.